bail bondswoman forced to bail herself out of jail, accused of pocketing thousands of dollars that should have been returned to clients.
State investigators arrested Vivian Santos at her business along Fowler Street yesterday. NBC2's Trent Kelly is live outside First Premier Bail Bonds with new information from Santos's arrest report.
Well, we just got our hands on that arrest report within the past couple of hours. In it, we learned Santos is accused of taking that cash nearly 2 years ago after a family walked inside her business here looking for help. Instead, some say that family was taken advantage of.
I just saw all the police out there. I didn't really know what was going on.
A bail bond business owner busted by state investigators who swarmed this shopping plaza off Fowler Street.
I was curious. I was watching. I was waiting to see what was going on.
Vivian Santos, the owner of First Premier Bail Bonds, was later let out in handcuffs. A newly obtained arrest report from the Florida Department of Financial Services shows Santos received a $2,500 upfront payment from a family trying to bond out their father here illegally. When it became clear he was never going to be released, Santos had 21 days to return that cash, something investigators say never happened.
They said that they went to the office a few times and the company refused to give them back the $2,500.
Frank Gonzalez is also a bail bondsman and was approached by the victims for help. He believes they were taken advantage of.
It upsets me a lot to have companies like that do these to private civilians, consumers. It actually hurts the whole industry.
He says this type of behavior may be more prevalent than most people think and applauds Santos's arrest.
I'm sure there's a lot of bail bond companies that do the same thing out there. I don't know who they are, okay? And they know who they are.
Now, despite her arrest, Santos's business did open its doors today. She told me off camera this whole thing is a misunderstanding, claiming it's the result of a simple paperwork error. Nevertheless, she does face two charges, including embezzlement and grand theft. I'm live in Fort Myers, Trent Kelly, NBC2.